So it will go down as a 1-1 draw this semi-final, and someone will lose on the penalty shootout and go to Rome in raptures. Yes, indeed, Shilton did win the toss, so Ildner goes onto the line. Lineker goes up to the ball. Now, we saw two sorts of penalties from Gary Lineker against Cameroon. His favourite method, the first one up, to put it with some power but some placement as well, and the second time just to blast it and hope for the best. Here he goes, and he blasts it, and England have drawn first blood. For West Germany, it's going to be Bremer, and I take you back to Mexico City and 1985. Shilton was the goalkeeper. It was England against West Germany. Bremer was the penalty taker, and Shilton saved it. Can he repeat the feat here? He can't. So 1-1. It's Peter Beardsley for England. Deliberate placement. Check with the referee so he can turn and take it in his own time. Beardsley for England. Yes! Ildner made a good try at a good penalty. Well, West Germany certainly sending the big hitters up early in the competition, because now it's Matthäus. Who's their number one penalty man. And that's why. I should think Shilton hardly saw that. And of all the penalty shootouts we've had and the penalties taken, I doubt if one's been hit harder than this. David Platt. So new to the international scene. But Aston Villa's penalty taker in league football. And he's done it for England. So it's 3-2 and he's off the hook. And every time England get one, it just puts that much more pressure on the following West German. It's a terribly overword used, pressure. I apologise for inflicting you with it, but you know what I'm getting at. There's stress out there. This is sport at its highest level, and on this day of destiny, the decision is drawing nearer and nearer. Riedler. Three-three. And England, as Shilton, like Ildner just before him, going the right way. But England would feel pretty happy about Stuart Pearce coming up in this situation. The man who doesn't mince his words and really doesn't mess about when it comes to hitting a football. Oh, and he's hit it too straight. And West Germany find it's tilting their way. It just went at the goalkeeper. He got all the force, but Ildner couldn't get out of the way. It came too quickly. And Lineker ruffles Pierce's hair and tries to make him feel better, but there's only one way to make him feel happier, and that's for England to get the better of this penalty, which is to be taken by Olaf Ton, and he's put it away. And they're in pole position, and they're through to the final if England fail now. And Shilton did his darnest, but Tom was too good for him. It's an unenviable task for Christopher Waddle. Pierce can't look. Here goes Waddle. Oh dear, it's West Germany. The favourites have got through by the narrowest of margins. They've reached a third consecutive World Cup final. And England's dreams of emulating their achievements of 1966 ended by penalty failure. Fortune and a fair amount of skill and nerve from the penalty spot for Franz Beckenbauer and his players. And for England, a defeat not at pure football, but through failure from 12 yards out, first from Pierce, then from Waddle. But much criticised in their own country, they've certainly defied those who call for their heads. Reaching the semi-final is a landmark in itself, but West Germany won't be satisfied until they get their hands on the World Cup, and they now confront Argentina, who pipped them 4 years ago. So it's Italy against England for third place, and the 1990 World Cup final between West Germany and Argentina.